21. The last class we have discussed about main window in the smartphone. In the main window, how can we insert a table, and in that table, how can we create the lines and header, main area, footer. We have inserted those lines and we have displayed the data. Okay, now I have one more requirement. So here total amount is coming. Okay, total amount is coming, something 30 net price, something is coming here, net price is coming here. So I want to display the amount. But here the amount is coming as zero. Okay, but in real time the data won't come like this. Okay, so I want to display the amount in words also. Okay, that will be in next line. Otherwise, here quantity is coming, right? So I don't want quantity here. Okay, total quantity is coming here, right? I don't want this quantity. Here total is coming, right? So after that total, I want to display that amount in words. Okay, how is it possible? We will check that one. Fine. Where is it? So first of all, we have to change the layout. Okay, but which layout we have to change? This quantity is the right. I don't want this quantity. I want to remove this quantity now. Okay, so where is it? It is in footer. Okay, total is coming in the footer. Okay, I will go for main area. So main window. Here table and footer is coming here. So in this footer, three columns are coming here. The line name is footer here. Okay, I want to change this one. Okay, I want to change. How can we change? We have to go for table here and this is the table here, and I don't want this one, this column. I don't want. I want to remove this one, right? So click on pencil button here. So this one, right? Just right click on it. Delete only this cell, not total line. Okay, I want to delete this L only. Click on this one. Click on S. Okay, so it's coming like this. Now I will adjust this one to here. Goodbye. Okay. And now we have to click on this one. Now this is okay, fine. Okay. I have removed one column in the footer line and I will come here. So this is the total and this is the total amount. Okay, total amount is coming here. Now I have to display the total and what is the amount field here. Okay, so as of now amount is coming as zero. I will take another sales document number. Here also, fine. Here something amount is coming, 17.55, like that it is coming. Okay, I have to see quantity is coming here. In the smart form, I have removed this column. Then also the quantity is coming because the smart form is not activated yet. Okay. So if it is activated, then it won't come. The quantity, total quantity won't come. But I did not activate the smart form. That's why the old version is coming here. Fine. Here, for this one, I want to display total amount 17 rupees, something 55 paise, like that I want to display. you. So this is the total amount. I'm double clicking on it. What is the variable? Which variable is containing this total amount? Okay. So LV underscore net price. Okay. LV underscore net price is a variable. It is containing the value. Okay. But I want to convert this one into words also. And here total is coming. Just double click on it. So this is the total. This is the hard coding. Okay. Total hard coding is coming. Here total is coming, right? Like this, the total is coming here. And after that one, okay, after the total semicolon, I will give an amount in words. I mean, 17 rupees 55 paise, like that I want to display. Okay. So how can we do that one? Here in the total, I will take something other price. Okay. Here in the total, I will create one program line. Okay, because I want to convert the amount. Okay, amount something is coming, 17.55 is coming. I want to convert that amount in words. That's why I have to write some logic. I have to use some function modules here. So if you want to write something logic in middle of the smart form, then we have to go for program lines. Okay. So how can we go? How can we create a program line here? Right click on it, click on create button, and click on flow logic, and click on program line. Okay, here I'm taking on program lines, and I will change the name here. Amount in words. Okay, amount in words logic. First of all, I have to find out one function module. Okay, so which function module mean? The amount is coming. I want to convert that one into word side. So some function modules will available. So we have to check for those function modules. 1 minute, I will check in Google. Lot of function modules will available. Okay, you can use anything. Function module to convert amount. Okay. Something they are giving like this. So I will take this one and I will check this one how it is working. Okay. First of all, I will go to AC37. Because I have to test this one, how it is working, I don't know exactly, right? So we have to test that one separately. So I'm going for AC37 transaction and I'm passing the function module name and I'm executing this one. So what is the input parameter, output parameter like that? See, input parameter is coming here, something amount I will pass here, like 17.55. Click on execute button. 17 rupees 55 paise. Okay. So it is working here. I'm giving something amount number and it is converting into something words. Okay. So I will take this one. I will use this function module. So this is the smart form. Here I want to call that smart form. Okay. Here I want to call that smart form. So if you want to call the smart form, so if you want to call the function module in a smart form, then we have to click on this button. Pattern is there, right? So in the AC38 transaction, the program level, the pattern will come in the top side. Okay, the shortcut key for that one is Control F6. So here pattern is coming here. Just click on this pattern button and provide a function module. Click on OK button. Okay, so it's coming like this. Okay, it is coming like this. And here amount in words. We have to pass the value. Here total amount is coming, right? So we have to take that variable and we have to pass here. This is a variable. and I will pass here. Okay, LV net price. And importing. In importing, I want to in importing, I have to import something value, right? So I will take a variable LV underscore AAW. Okay, amount in watts. Okay, local variable amount in watts. So exceptions are coming. I will uncomment the exceptions here. Okay, and now I did not declare this LV underscore AAW. First of all, I have to declare that one. But what is the type? How can I declare this one? So what is the data type here? Data type and length. How much I have to take here? So click and display the function module. Click on export tab. See here, it is taking only C. Okay, amount in words, it is coming like C only, but they did not maintain any length here, specific length they did not declare here. Fine. Now I will come here. LV underscore AAW, right? I will go for local, global definitions. LV underscore AAW, right? Care 100 or 200. Okay, let me check that one. 100 is enough. Click and check this one. It's okay. Now I'm coming to the click and check button. So it will throw some errors here. LV underscore net price is unknown. Okay. So we are using something input values here and we are getting something output. Okay. So those are all things we have to maintain in the input and output parameters in the program lines. LV underscore net value, net price, and LV underscore AAW. Now click and check button. Okay, there is no error. Now save it. And the total, I want to display this LV underscore AAW, something amount is converting into a variable. I have to pass that variable now. So the total is coming here, right? Double click on this total. See, the text field is coming here. Okay, before that one only, I am converting the data. Okay, if you write this logic, okay, after this text file, okay, then the data won't display because the calculation, these all things are going on after displaying the data. Okay, so before displaying the data only, we have to calculate that one. We have to convert that one. So we have to take this program line before the text here and click on this button. Total is coming like this, and I'm giving something like this. And so the variable I'm passing here, LV underscore AAW, amount in watts. Okay, total is something hard coding. Okay, and after that one, I'm giving something semicolon. And I'm starting ampersand, means I'm passing something variable here. Okay, ampersand LV underscore AAW. What is the value is coming? That value will display here. Click on back. Check it. Activate the smartphone. Okay, it's activated now. I will go to the program. I will execute it one more time. Click on back button. I am clicking on execute button one more time. Click on print preview. Here total amount 17 rupees 55 paise. The amount is coming like this. Fine. Now I have one more requirement. So the heading is coming here, right? So the heading, I want to display the text in the center. Something alignment. Okay, I want to do something alignment here. So the sales document number, S4 number is coming, and I want to display something bold color, some thickness. Okay, I have to give some thickness for this S1 underscore number. Okay, and I want to give something color for this one. Okay, S1 number, I want to give something color and something thickness and center alignment. Okay, this is the left alignment. Okay. Here I am writing something. Okay, so how it is, I mean, so the letters are starting from left side, okay, but I want to display the data from the right side. Okay, this is the right alignment. Okay, now I want to display the data in the center. The same way here also, I mean in the smart form also, left alignment, right alignment and center alignment, some alignments will be there. Okay, so the same way I want to display the SO number, SO item, material quantity and net price, headings, heading information I want to display in the center alignment. Okay, and something thickness and something color. Okay, so if you want to apply something colors to the smart form, or if you want to apply something alignment to the smart form, then we have to go for one more transaction, that is smart styles. Okay, smart styles is a transaction code, and there we can apply the colors. I'm executing that one, smart style. Okay, smart styles, click on enter. So style name we have to provide here. Okay, style name or the smart form name, I am taking same thing here. Otherwise, you can take any other name also. Okay. Okay, ZSSTY1. Okay, ZSmartStyle1. Click on create button. Okay, so style something. Description, if you want to provide something description, we can provide here smart style one. Okay, now here something is coming like paragraph and character format. Okay, paragraph format and character format means here total something, just assume something data is coming like one paragraph. Okay, the data is starting in the first line and it is ending in the something seventh line like that. Okay, so these seven lines are one paragraph. I want to apply something color, or I want to apply something alignment for the text, total text is seven lines text, because this is belongs to one paragraph. Okay, so in this case we can go for paragraph. Okay, here paragraph format is coming. And character format is coming. So here I want to display something here. Total amount is coming here like this, right? So total is coming normally, and 17 rupees 55 paise. I want to display something thick color. Okay, so in middle of the line, okay, in middle of the line, if you want to display something differently the text, then we have to go for character format. Okay, character format and paragraph format, two things will be there. Okay, character format means in one line for particular alphabets. Okay, for particular alphabets, if you want to apply something color or thickness or alignment, then we can go for character format. Okay, total Something on paragraph will be there. Total paragraph I want to display in one alignment. Then we can go for paragraph alignment. Okay. So first of all, I will go for something paragraph format. Okay. I have to create something paragraph format here. Okay. Click on create node here. Okay. And here something default. Okay. So first of all, I am creating a default paragraph format. Okay, click on OK button. And here it is asking something left alignment. Okay, so automatically it came here left align. Okay. And incident. So something left margin, right margin. So and spacing is coming here. So what is the meaning of this part? Okay, this is a left alignment, right? If you want to provide something gap in the from left side. For example, this is a left alignment. So if you want to give something space in the left side, like this, then we have to go for something spacing like that. Okay. So as of now, I'm not doing here anything. So click on save button. Will throw something error, I think. Okay. So the one paragraph format I'm taking it. I'm not providing any. Thickness I'm not providing, colors I'm not providing, nothing is providing here. This is a default thing. Okay. So if you are creating any smart style, okay, if you are creating any smart style, at that time we have to create one default paragraph format. Okay. So first of all, we have to do that one, default paragraph format. Okay. You can give any name here. Okay. The format name I'm giving as DE. Okay. The description I'm giving as default. You can give any name here. Okay, only two characters we can provide. More than two characters, you cannot provide for the name. Okay, and here header data is there. Okay, double click on this header data, and here standard paragraph is there. This is a mandatory thing, that's why I'm telling. Okay, so if you don't provide like this, it will throw error, it won't activate. Okay, first of all, we have to create one default paragraph format, and the default paragraph format we have to pass in the header data. Okay, in the standard paragraph here it is asking DE. Okay, so if you create 2-3 paragraphs here, those 2-3 paragraph names will come here. Okay, so that's why I have taken DE first of all, and I am applying the DE here. Okay, this is a default parameter. Means this the smart form, total smart form. Okay, so it will update the default paragraph format. Okay, default paragraph format. And now I will come to the one more thing. So paragraph formats are there, right? So right click on it, click on create node. Now I want to apply something heading. Okay, heading. So HE I am taking. So click on OK button. The description I am giving as heading. Okay, or header. Okay, header. And here the alignment. The alignment is the center alignment. Okay, centered alignment. And click on font here. Okay, if you want to apply something font family, means something text. So this is the text here, right? So this is the text here, right? So this is the font family. Okay, you can see the text is changing here. Okay, this is the font family here. Okay, so if you want to apply something font family, then you can apply here. Okay, so if you don't pass, then by default it will take something. Okay, and font size. Okay, so if you want to increase the size here for displaying, this is the font I want to apply the something extra size here. Okay, so if you want to apply some size, you can provide something size here, but I am not providing anything. So by default it will come something size. Okay, something 11 like that it will come. And font style. Font style means something bold, italic. I am taking here something bold. I want something thickness, so I am taking here bold. Okay, and color is coming here. Okay, so I am selecting this checkbox, and I will apply something color here, like something green color I am applying. Okay, something green color I am applying, and save it, activate it. Okay, it's activated. Now, what is smart style here? The smart style name I am copying here. So I have to apply this smart style. Okay, I have to apply this smart style in our smart form. So I will come to the smart form now. So where we have to apply that smart style in our smart form? The form attributes only. Here output options are available. Click on here. Here output format is coming here. Sorry, style is coming here. Okay, so system is coming. By default, system will generate. SAP is creating one system smart style. Okay, so in place of this one, I will apply my smart style. Okay, that is STY1, smart style 1. Okay, now save it, activate it. Now it's activated, fine. Now, so where do you want to apply this one? In the header, okay? In the header, I want to apply that one, right? So I will go for header. So this is the text, right? Double click on this text. This is the SO number. Okay, so for this SO number, I want to apply some center alignment and some thick color on something green color. Okay, so here. It is not applying here, right? So here, something default and HE is coming. Okay, how it is coming? I'm copying that smart style name and I am passing the global definitions. Okay, the form attributes. Okay, the form attributes, I'm passing the smart style name. Okay, so how many characters are there? How many character formats are there? How many paragraph formats are there? Those all things will come in this smart form now. Okay, so for this text, how many paragraph formats are there? Those all paragraph formats will come here. Okay. Now I'm double clicking on the text here, and here something style is coming. Okay. Click on this style and click on some header information. Header style. Here it is coming like this. We will see that green color is coming or not. We will see in the output. So here I have applied a green color for HE. Green color I have applied. Okay, so we will check in the output how it will come. Here the green color is not applying. Center alignment is applying and some bold is applying for that text. Okay, and next one. Next one, this SO item. So for this item also, I want to apply the same thing. Okay, the header. The name is HE here. Just click on that button, automatically the data will align here. Next one is this one, right? So material is coming here. Okay, so it is coming in the MS Word. If you are using something old version or ERP server like that, then MS Word won't come for a few users. It will come like this. Okay, here star is there. Remove that star, and here SAP providing some here it is not coming anything, right? I will provide here like HE. Okay, HE I am providing. Click on back. So automatically it will apply here. Okay, automatically it will apply here. So you can go for like that, or you can directly select the style here. Okay, and next one, quantity. So for quantity also, I am applying the same thing. Okay, now activate the smart lock. So execute the smart farm one more time. See here, S1 number, S4 item, material, quantity, net price is coming in the center alignment and bold, something bold it is applied and green color is coming. Okay, now I have one more requirement, like here something one is coming here, the quantity is coming like one, but it is coming the left alignment, but the quantity or net price should come in the right alignment. Okay, so it should not come from left alignment. I want to apply one more alignment here, right alignment, the quantity and net price. Okay, I will create one more alignment here in the smart style. I will create one more alignment here, the paragraph format, click on create node here. This is a right alignment, right? For a right alignment, I am taking this one. Right alignment, and the alignment is coming as right. Just RA, that's it. I mean, right alignment, that's it. That I'm not changing the text here. Okay, size or color, I'm not doing anything here. Just activate it. It's activated. Okay, now I will use this RA. Okay, I will use that RA in the smart form. So this is the header, and the main area is there. In the main area, so the quantity and the net price, right? So double click on this quantity here. So style is coming. You can apply right alignment. Okay. Automatically it will come. So if you activate the smart style, automatically it will apply here. For the net price also, I am applying the same thing. Okay, right alignment, activate it. Click on back button. Now quantity is coming the left alignment. I will check it once again. Click on execute button. Click on print preview. Here quantity is coming the right element and the net price is coming the right element, and here also, okay, the total amount also should come in the right element only. Okay, so that will come in the footer. Okay, the footer, the last total amount. Okay, activate it. Total is coming also in the right alignment. Fine. Fine. This is fine. Now I have one more requirement. Okay, I have one more requirement here. So what is the company here? Okay, the company address I want to display here. Okay, I want to display something company address. Company address means, so you are maintaining something company. Okay, you have one company. So something, one customer is ordering something. At that time only you are creating something SO or billing or something delivery document like that, right? So you have to maintain your company information also. What is the company number, company name, company address? So this all information you have to maintain here, the top. Okay, the top you have to maintain the company information. Okay, and the customer information is coming, right? This customer information you have to pass beside that one. Okay, so first of all, I want to display something, company information here. Company information, I mean company name, company address. So I have to maintain those things. Okay, and after that one, I want to apply something customer information here. Customer information. Okay, and